20th. We close the book. Where you boys been working? Up around we? You too? Well, then. Yeah, him too. The boss pointed a playful finger at Lenny. He ain't much of a talker, is he?
No, he ain't. But he sure held a good worker. Strong as a bull.
Lenny smiled to himself. Strong as a bull. He repeated. George scowled at him, while Lenny dropped his head in shame at having forgotten. The boss said suddenly, "Listen, Small." Lenny raised his head. "What can you do?" In a panic, Lenny looked at George for help. "He can do anything tell him," said George. "He's a good skinner. He can wrestle grain bags, drive a cultivator. He can do anything. Just give him a try." The boss turned on George. "Why don't you let him answer? What you trying to put over?" George spoke in loudly. "Oh, I ain't saying he's right. He ain't. But I say he's a goddamn good worker. He can put up a 400-pound bale." The boss deliberately put the little book in his pocket. He hit his thumb from his belt and squinted one eye nearly closed. "Say, what you selling?" "Huh?" I said, "What stake you got in this guy? You taking his pay from him?" "No, of course I ain't." "Why, you think I'm selling him out?" "Well, I never seen one guy take so much trouble for another guy. Like to know what your interest is." George said, "She's my cousin. I told the old lady after the party. He got kicked in the head by a horse when he was a kid. And he's all right, just ain't right. But he can do anything to kill him." The boss turned half away. "Well, I'm driving over if you don't give me any brains about garden bears. But don't you try to keep nothing over me. I got my eye on you. Why'd you quit weed? Job was done?" "What kind of job?" "We was digging a cesspool." "All right. But don't try to put nothing over, because you can't get away with nothing. I've seen wise guys before. Going out with the grain teams after dinner. Picking up barley at the threshing machine. Go out with Slim's team. Slim?" "Yeah. They call Skinner. You've seen it dinner." He turned abruptly and went to the door, but before he went out, he turned and looked for a long moment at the two men. When he sounded his footsteps and died away, George turned on him. "So, he wasn't going to say a word. He was going to leave your big flat and shut, and we need you to the coffee. You damn near lost his job." And he stared hopelessly at his hands.
"I'm not going."
"Yeah, you can exactly always forget, and I got to talk you out of it." He sat down heavily on the bunk. "Now he's got his eye on us. Now we got to be careful and not make no slips.